Okay, guys, welcome to GambolMe, and today I'm going to interview my good friend, Charlie McGing. We've been friends now for a couple of years, been hanging around quite a lot. He's improved my diet and nutrition, he's improved my gym regime, and he's got me onto a lot of supplements that have helped me a lot. And I think having an interview with a guy like this who's been into fitness for 6 years now, I think it is,
yeah,
and you've trained people for a year, over 100 clients I think now,
yeah,
including more as well. You've made a few more clients have signed up as well, like to get this part of the life handled. So yeah, what I'd do is get an interview today, get some basics handled for you guys, get some information for you guys, so you can go to the gym and improve yourself in health, fitness, and, you know, bodybuilding.
Yeah, boy.
Cool. Talk about yourself. What have you been doing? What do you do?
So, yeah, I've been into fitness for the last 6 years. So I've been training consistently for the past 6 years. Been going out quite a bit. Just moved to Barcelona with Toby and Nick and a few of the other guys. So doing a bit of business stuff, hitting gym hard, and enjoying life, man.
How long have you been going to the gym for? How long have you been training for?
So I've been training consistently for about 6 years. But first couple of years was kind of like a bit of a fuck around. Like, most people kind of spend the first year or two basically making no gains and trying to lift heavy, but not making actually any muscle gains. So did that for a couple of years. Wish I had a fucking program to stick to. But yeah, last 4 years has been serious, like consistently training, doing competitions. And then I've been doing my online coaching stuff for just over a year now. So,
do you remember how you first started? Do you remember what it was that got you into weight training or just going to the gym?
Got me into weight training?
Just got you into the gym for the start. What made you walk into the gym for the first time?
Yeah. Well, I played rugby for like 6 years and then I just didn't do anything like at all for like 2 years. And then there's some like other guys in my school that were like quite big. And yeah, there was like that, you know, that thing like where you see like a couple of popular guys and then you're like, oh yeah, like they're big or whatever.
Yeah.
If I get big, then yeah, I'll be like popular.
The common stereotype of if I build muscle, you know.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, that's kind of what we've got me in. But then I just started to really enjoy training, lifting heavy. Yeah, so that's why I've kept on going for all this time, just because.
Well, it became one of your passions, I believe, right? It became one of your like hobbies, main hobbies, biggest, yeah, one of your biggest passions, I believe.
For sure, like definitely, probably my biggest passion, to be honest. Like, got like going out and other stuff that I really enjoy as well. But you know, there's no other feeling like lifting some like really heavy weight at the gym.
Yeah, man, I think from the time I've known you, I think one of the things that first struck me when I first met you and stuff is how much of your day, or like, I don't know, you meet a lot of people who go to the gym and stuff, and they go to the gym, they drink a protein shake, they eat a certain set of meals, and that's like, that's it, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
I think you're a lot more deep into it, like you're always drinking some sort of drink, like a superfood, yeah, drink, or you're always taking different types of supplements, or you're always eating a meal or eating something to keep carbs. You're a lot
for
more
sure,
serious,
yeah,
about it than maybe your average gym goer, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Where do you think you started to realise that you wanted to do it as a hobby, and you know that's where you wanted to go with the weight training?
I wanted to do it as a hobby.
Yeah, like, I mean, like you would have got into it, right, and then you wouldn't have thought, right, I'm going to do this for 6 years and I'm going to get like,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah. Well, first of all, yeah, I really enjoyed it and stuff, just the training itself. But then, like, the rest of it, so you see, like, basically me doing little things all day to kind of boost my progress in that area and other areas of my life and stuff. And that's basically just because it's like a game. You know, like, I used to be obsessed with games when I was younger, where you'd, like, you do something, you do like do a quest or something, you get like money from it, and then you like you upgrade your character or whatever, or like,
yeah,
fucking Pokemon or some shit where you like level up, so you like you can view life exactly the same. And so for me, like when I have like breakfast and I eat, you know, exactly what I need to optimize my training, like my going out, my health and all that stuff, I'm thinking like, this is like leveling me up, Yeah. So it's kind of, it's like fun, it becomes a game.
I guess it's progression you can actually see. You can actually monitor your progression in the gym, right? I assume, like, because there's a lot of different skills you can get into, especially, you know, in the self-help industry or whatnot, and you can't really see any actual progression. You've got to kind of, like, understand where you're at with it. Whereas gym, I guess, you can physically actually measure yourself, or you can watch yourself lift heavier weights. Like, you can physically see the leveling up that you're going through.
Yeah.
And you can, you know, I suppose, figure out where you're going wrong or how you can possibly improve as well. That's pretty cool. So when you first got into it, were you making a lot of the common mistakes, I assume? Like,
yeah,
a lot of the everyday common mistakes that everybody makes when they first go to the gym. So let's talk about those for a start. Let's muscle those guys, for the new guys who are going to the gym or guys who haven't gone to the gym yet.
Yeah.
We're not going to hammer you on it, as in like some guy who's going to come up behind you and then say, hey, that form could be a little bit better, anything. Like, we're not going to, like, you know, torment you or anything. These are just some things possibly that you might have done or you've seen people do that is very common, and is like, it's something that will help you in the long run if they stop doing.
Yeah.
Would you say it's possibly form?
For sure. Like, first year of doing bench press, I, you know, I got up to like 80 kg bench press, but I wasn't really doing it properly. So I was going up in weight a little bit, but I was just like bringing it down to like half weight and then bring it up. I thought like, oh yeah, I'm a fucking boss. Like, I can do 80 kg after like, you know, half a year or something. But I saw no chest development. And so basically I just completely wiped it clean, started like going down to the chest and doing it properly. Obviously you couldn't lift as much weight, but started making proper muscle development. So at the beginning, like, that's probably the main thing, is to get the lift down in a way that you know it's contracting your muscles and you know that you're stimulating your muscles by doing it, not just lifting heavy weight, like something that's actually going to make you grow if you're into like bodybuilding, if that's what you're going for.
Yeah, certainly. So basically make sure the exercises you're doing are properly tearing the muscle in the right way.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's like, otherwise I suppose you're running a marathon with your shoes tied, right?
Yeah, pretty like, much. Like, you're just doing stuff that's not really going to
help your gains or get you to where you actually want to be. That's the reason you went to the gym, basically.
Yeah.
What about any other, like, you know, common newbie mistakes that they make at the gym? Let me think.
Well, say for guys that, like, struggle to put on muscle and they, like, struggle to put on weight and stuff, it's basically just not eating enough. There's loads of guys that go down the gym who just don't eat enough and they just don't grow. You can train, I could train for 6 years, exactly how I've done, but be exactly the same as I started if I hadn't eaten more. So, say I started on like, you know, 2,000 calories, now I'm on like 4,500. If you want to improve, you just have to keep eating more and more.
For sure, man, that's quite interesting, because you eat, how many times a day do you eat? How many meals have you got?
Probably about five, but like they're kind of long meals.
How many calories are you on a day?
4,500.
4,500 calories. So, I mean, like, for somebody to take it seriously and seriously want to bulk up, the basic principle of eat more, your muscles need more food, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, yeah, for somebody who's new and who wants to get really big, if your metabolism works fast, you'll need to, you know, take that into account, I assume.
Yeah, exactly.
And eat more. And then if you want the bigger you want to get, the more you have to eat. It's like a, you know, a common...
Exactly. And, like, at the beginning, you know, eating more, you're like, fuck, I feel shit, like, my stomach's full. Blah, blah, blah. Like, your stomach stretches and you get used to how much you eat. If you eat, like, if you overeat for a couple of weeks, your stomach just gets bigger. So it just becomes normal. So, like, 4,500 calories, like, although I spend a bit of time eating, it's not like, you know, my stomach is bursting all the time. Unless
I
have to eat quickly, obviously. Then
yeah,
I, like, nearly throw up before going out or whatever.
The same happens... The same happens the other way around, right? If you've got an overstretched stomach and you start eating less a day, I hear it does contract back to an amount. Obviously not like extreme if you're massively overweight and your stomach's stretched to an extreme amount, but I hear it does contract back again. And you can eat smaller amounts of food and feel full over a period of time. So that's quite interesting.
So I mean, if you're trying to lose weight, it works the opposite way. So if you start eating smaller amounts of food, realise that in the future, that's going to be normal for you, you know. You won't need to, you know, you won't feel hungry. You won't feel like your stomach isn't full anymore.
Yeah.
You just get used to the amount of food that you eat.
Is there anything else you notice that newbies do in the gym that you know, could get them better. Do you think it's necessarily important for a newbie to go into the gym who wants to build muscle to start right away on protein shake? Or do you think it's... Well, actually, I'd say the best way to find out if it's ready for protein shake or not, I'd say, is to find out exactly how much protein you need, find out how much protein you're eating.
For sure, yeah. Start, even if you're a newbie, like, if you want to make, you know, if you want to progress fast, macros are still going to be what's the main thing to make you grow along with the training.
Should we have a talk about macros? So what are macros in a nutshell?
Okay, so macros are carbs, proteins and fats, your macronutrients basically. And, you know, they're basically what constitute calories. So, you know, the ratio of different macronutrients gives you slightly different results because they do different things. Although, say if you want to lose weight, then you have to be below calories. If you want to gain weight, you have to be above calories. But the ratio of carb, protein and fat, how much you're having of each, kind of can really affect your body type, can affect your hormones, how much your muscles are recovering, and how much energy you have. This can be different to everyone, so you kind of need to figure it out for yourself, or, you know, get a trainer to kind of help you out, help do that for you.
Yeah, sure. So, like, basically, for the guys who want to lose weight, you need to find out how many calories you need to maintain weight and be underneath that, right?
If they're trying to lose weight?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you have to be in a calorie deficit, so you have to be underneath maintenance calories.
Yep, and if you want to gain weight, you need to find out maintenance calories and eat more calories.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And if you want to build muscle, you need to eat a certain amount of protein, if I'm right?
Yeah, well, protein contributes to muscle growth and your recovery, especially for, you know, natural guys. Protein is important. But if you're, carbs and fats can be better than protein, especially, like, if you're cutting. Sometimes, you know, if you're in a calorie deficit, you don't need, like, 300 grams of protein or something. So there's a range that protein works well, and, like, above that, you're kind of just, you know, you're converting that protein into glucose anyway, so you may as well eat carbs.
Right, interesting. So, yeah, that's quite interesting. And so for somebody who's new, it's not necessarily important for him to straight away hit a protein shake. If he's eating the right amount of protein, it'd be a waste of time, and you might as well eat it in a different way.
Yeah, well, protein shakes, the main reason for protein shakes is for, you know, a quick protein source straight after the gym, basically, so you can feed your muscles with protein straight after, get the recovery process going. Plus, as well, to bulk up your maximum, you know, total protein for the day. You know, a lot of people don't even take protein shakes, they just eat straight up high protein foods. So yeah, as long as you're hitting your protein for the day, then that's the main
thing.
That's
fine, yeah. Awesome. So what we'll do is we'll talk about bodybuilding a little bit later, but for now let's talk about fat loss. Awesome. So yeah, so let's talk about fat loss first. I think that's one of the main reasons people get into the gym. And then later on, let's talk about bodybuilding for the guys who want to take their body to, you know, a really curved, toned physique, who want to move towards that. So starting with fat loss, there's so much to say about this because the industry is booming at the moment for people who want to lose weight and look healthier because, funnily enough, society's moved in a way where thin people are now attractive. So let's talk about the basics of losing weight. What exactly needs to happen, regardless of fad diets, regardless of pills, meal replacements, you know, Atkins diet and all that lot. Let's talk about the basics of what needs to happen to lose weight.
For sure. So to lose weight, you need a calorie deficit. So that's the main thing. You have to find out what your maintenance calories are and then eat consistently at a calorie deficit every day. So you need to start tracking, you know, how much you're eating, basically, and hitting that deficit each day. And so that's how you're going to slowly lose weight.
Yeah, so find out your metabolism rate.
Yeah.
And find out how much calories you need to maintain the weight you're currently at.
Yeah.
Find out exactly how much that is, and then eat under that, right?
Yeah.
And your body will automatically start burning fat to make up for the, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
And, what methods do you know to find out how much, what the metabolism is for a person?
So what I normally do is you basically track what you normally eat for like a few days. Just eat the same things and see how your weight fluctuates after a few days. If your weight hasn't changed for them few days, then you know that that is the amount of food that you need to maintain, you know, your metabolism. So just track it for a few days and see. And then like if you lose weight, then increase it a little bit and see if you lose weight, and just play around with it until you know.
Yeah. So you need to find out how many calories. So would you say weigh yourself every week on a Monday? Eat a diet that you can stick to Monday to Sunday.
Yeah.
And if you put on weight, you need to eat less calories per day.
Yeah.
If you've lost weight, then play around with it if you want to maintain, or if you want to gain weight, eat more, or, you know.
Exactly.
Base it off that, basically.
But, bear in mind, like, if you're a guy with a lot of muscle, then just eating a calorie deficit doesn't necessarily mean you're burning pure fat. You know, you could be burning muscle and stuff as well, depending on how you plan out your training and your diet. So once you, for, you know, normal people who are just trying to lose a bit of weight, you aren't too bothered about muscle mass, then you just eat a calorie deficit and then that's it. Basically, you just lose the weight, and like majority of that's probably going to be fat. When it comes down to guys, you know, that want to maintain like a high muscle mass as well, that's when it starts to get a little bit more complicated, because you're trying to preserve that muscle as well as, you know, just get rid of fat. It's like, if your body's in like survival mode, then, which is basically what a calorie deficit is, like survival mode, you burn your body reserves, then, you know, your body is not going to discriminate between fat and muscle unless, you know, you tailor it properly, you tailor it well. Because if you're like in the wild, like getting killed by like running away from lions and shit, you know, your body's not going to hold on to muscle, because you just want to like run away and survive and stuff.
Yeah, so your body starts to burn muscle, right?
Yeah, it's like a waste.
Yeah, so that's something to definitely keep your eye on while you're in a calorie deficit and building muscle at the gym.
For sure.
So keep an eye on, you know, are you burning fat or are you losing muscle? That's definitely something you don't want to happen, otherwise you're just going backwards once again. It's like if you're not lifting weights properly. That's cool. Do you know, I assume you know a lot about these diets that are out there. A lot of them are complete rubbish, and a lot of them are like, eat this meal, we'll deliver meals to your door. Like some of them are like, we'll deliver meals to your door for breakfast, dinner and tea.
Yeah.
Make sure you go to the gym, you will lose weight. And that's kind of like, it's kind of like what you do, really, with a meal plan, except you're not actually cooking their food for them. Mm-hmm. You're like saying, like, they punch in their calorie amount and they send them meals based on that and say, go to the gym and you'll lose weight. Whereas you're just giving them a meal plan instead of cooking them food. It's the same thing, right? Some of them are like, for example, Slim Fast. It's like, drink this instead of having a meal. Would you recommend anything like that?
Anything like Slim Fast? No, like food is always better. I mean, if you can get something from food, then it's always best to go for whole food. But in terms of like, you know, your physical fitness and your body and stuff, like macros probably are like the main thing. But then say like your health and the rest of your life is going to be fucking shit if you're eating Slim Fast and stuff like that all day. So I mean, like, most of the stuff that I do, you know, is not necessarily to do with fitness. It's to do with like maintaining fitness and growing a fitness while still having like the rest of my life, still improving the rest of life, rather than just being like walking around like, my body's so good but like I can't fucking think or like can't do function. Anything because I'm eating like
not eating
fucking
enough for the good
meal
stuff.
Replacements all day and shit. So
yeah, definitely. Would you, I'd say the general advice that is out there on like bodybuilding sites and stuff, and what the general community goes for, in my opinion, from what I've found, is generally watch your macros. So exactly, monitor exactly how many calories you're eating per day, find out how much you need and lower it, exactly like we said earlier. On the topic of fad diets, do you know of the low-carb diet or the ketosis diet?
Yeah, so I've done it a few times, and you know, it's one of them things that some people, you know, their body type just doesn't really work for it. Some people it's really good. I find it works quite well for me, because you know, I find that having higher fat diet and lower carbs, I can kind of have more energy over a long period of time, rather than having like quick spurts of energy and then like feeling tired and stressed and shit like that. I find I can have better energy levels and better testosterone if I do, you know, more fats and lower carbs. But I say like to never really do just no carbs whatsoever, because you know it is like an essential nutrient for your body. So you know, if I'm doing that kind of diet, you know, maybe I'll just have like low carbs in the day and then load up on carbs at night. So because it is important for muscle glycogen, and it's important for you know, to fuel your brain and stuff like that. So that's basically my take on it.
Yeah, interesting. That's quite interesting. So yeah, so we've covered basics in the gym. Make sure you're doing the muscle. Make sure you're doing the weights correctly. Losing weight, what you need is a calorie deficit. So I'd say look into the diets or whatever you've paid for and purchased into, and make sure that you realise that is still is what's required. Try and eat meals if you can instead of meal replacements. Monitor your food with macros. A good app for that, by the way, is MyFitnessPal. I think that's a really cool app for that. I think you do as well, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, that's quite a cool app. You can monitor how many calories anything's got. You can also use your phone to scan barcodes on packets.
I'm just going to show you the
and it'll like
the macros
tell you exactly. Yeah, like, it's pretty cool for that. Yeah, that's right. So let's dive into bodybuilding and then answer some questions. So for the guys out there that want to build muscle and look really good, not necessarily huge, but let's say the guy who goes to the gym has lost some weight and he's thinking, oh, now I want a six pack. Now I want like some muscles. Now I want to look quite toned and whatnot. What would you advise to a guy like that? What would you say to him?
He wants to build some muscle mass.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. So, obviously, like a muscle building routine, muscle building training routine, like hypertrophy sets. So, you know, 8 to kind of 15 reps. And then, basically sorting out your macros, eating in a calorie surplus, make sure you're eating enough calories. And
so this is a surplus, this, right, to build muscle? So you need to be in a calorie surplus so your muscles can be fed enough to grow, right?
Exactly. So when you're in a calorie surplus, you like give your body the environment to allow it to grow. So when you're in a deficit, you can't grow. It's the opposite. Yeah. So when you're in a surplus, your anabolic can grow more. Say, you know, get your fats high, get your carbs high, try and find ways to boost your testosterone levels if you're like a natural guy.
What are some ways you know how to build testosterone?
To boost testosterone, like eating healthy, like not too much sugars, keep the fats high, eat cholesterol, so like eggs, you know, eating like 12 eggs a day at the moment. Eggs have quite a bit of cholesterol.
We'll get into the joys of your diet in a bit.
Yeah.
Some of the awesome superfoods you've got, it was pretty cool.
Yeah. And, other ways to boost testosterone. Train heavy. I found, like, eating some fruit or something during training helps to boost testosterone quite a lot.
You go for bananas, right?
Yeah, bananas during training, because when you're training, you can spike your cortisol quite a lot. You can put your body into, like, a high-stress mode. So eating a banana, some like simple, simple sugars in the form of fruit, is going to help boost your testosterone levels that way by reducing your cortisol.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. So increase the weight that you're lifting, increase the food that you're eating. Anything else?
Just fucking go for it at the gym, man. Yeah. Keep the consistency and just like, don't be afraid to lift heavy. So if you're a natural guy, you just got to lift heavy, man. Like, you got to do your high rep stuff, but don't do low weight. You just won't grow. You need to do heavy weight and high reps.
Yeah, cool. That's quite interesting. Let's dive into your diet. Now, you eat, how many times a day again do you eat?
Well, like 5 times, but five with meals. A few snacks and shit.
5 meals with food in between, that's to maintain the muscle that you have at the moment. So, for the guys that are watching, if you want to build a lot of muscle, like Charlie, for example, it does mean you're going to have to eat more because your muscles need food, you know?
Yeah.
So that's something that I think people don't realise that they need to take into consideration is that if you build muscle, you need to eat more. So you eat five times a day, but I realise a lot of your foods that you eat have a lot of superfoods in them. Superfoods like kale, for example. You eat a lot of kale, right? And kale's classed as a superfood.
Yeah.
What else do you eat this? So in the morning, how does your morning start? Supplements and then breakfast?
Man, we'd probably be here all day if I went through like all the supplements. But I prep, normally prep in the morning. Like wake up, have some water, keep some supplements just like by my bedside. So like while I'm groggy and waking up, I can just like quickly have them to get the day started. Things like reishi mushroom, like B complex, vitamin C, ginseng.
I think reishi mushrooms really good as well. For the guys that are watching, reishi mushrooms, golden.
Yeah.
Definitely a good supplement.
Yeah. Good for social situations because it means you can just chat shit off your head for like...
Yeah, it wakes your mind up, I believe. Like, it wakes my mind up a bit.
To be honest though, most of the stuff that I take in terms of supplements, like they're not to do with muscle building. The only thing I take for muscle building are a few pre-workout things like citrulline malate, green tea powder, and beta-alanine, and then creatine and protein powder. Like, I take loads of other supplements, but it's all for health, because it means I can work out harder, it means, you know, I don't get as much stress in my body from working out, and it's just for like, health and other stuff, really. If you're a natural guy, and you want to, like, you want to be really good, you want to be the best, then you've got to do stuff, you know, that other people aren't doing. Stuff like supplements like horny goat weed, sorting out health stuff, make sure your testosterone levels are like as high as they can possibly be. You know, it's some of the things that's going to help give you that extra edge.
Yeah, that's quite interesting. Cool. And so in terms of superfoods, what's in your green juice? Did you mention that?
Yeah, so green juice, like the main point of the green juice is to just get like a whole fucking bag of kale in my body, like with the least effort possible. So I basically put a whole bag of kale in there, in the juice, and then just like an apple, ginger, garlic, celery, and cucumber. So and then I put it in like a bottle and then I just like drink it with my meals.
How many of those do you have a day?
So I make one in the morning and then I split it between three meals.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. If you like split up your greens into a few meals, you know, you can, it's kind of like a building effect.
Yeah.
So you get the benefits like more than if you just drank it all in one go.
There you go, there's a green juice you guys can try out back at home, that's pretty cool. And I do believe you make a curry, which is a superfood curry, I'd say.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
It's got some interesting stuff in it, right? Talk about that.
Yeah, so when I do like high carb days and stuff, it's kind of high fat as well, really. But it's like brown rice, brown basmati rice. But then I make this curry sauce. The full recipe is like on my channel, if you want to check it out. But it's basically like coconut cream and then like loads of spices, turmeric, pepper, and shiitake mushrooms and stuff like that. So, you know, that's like a really healthy way that you can get in a lot of calories. If you check out like coconut cream, you get like a packet like this, which is like 1,000 calories per packet. It's like this big. And, you know, it's like healthy calories as well because it's coconut fat. It's not like, like bad fats and stuff.
That's right, cool.
So yeah, good way to get a lot of calories in some healthy way.
Yeah, so check out some of his superfoods on his channel, Charlie McGing, right, at YouTube.
Yeah.
Yep, there's some superfoods on there that are quite cool to check out. I do remember that you've seen your curry one. I've seen your smoothie one on there as well, exactly how to make the smoothie one. I'm sure he's got more coming out as well as different types of supplements as well on top of that.
Yep.
Let's talk about anything else you've got to say about bodybuilding. What else do you do per day other than eat, take supplements, and you sleep? I'd say, it blends into like health and fitness. You're quite on top of your sleep as well. I'd say, in terms of everybody I know who's into health and fitness, a lot of people do like minute things, but you take your health serious. Like, you know, you monitor everything that you do day by day. You monitor how you feel day by day, and you kind of adjust all the time to make sure that you're always at optimal, you know, working mode.
Yeah, exactly. Like, in terms of like health, you know, for me, my main focus for health is not like, oh, I'm going to like live really long and I'm not going to die and stuff like that. Which, you know, for most people, like, that's what they kind of think in terms of health. Like, you know, when their mum gets them to like eat some fucking greens and shit.
And they get long hair.
Yeah. It's like, oh, I'm going to live so long now.
See, in the dark now, I've eaten all my carrots.
Yeah. But like, that's not why you want to do it. You want to do it so you feel fucking good all the time.
Yeah.
And you've got energy all the time. And your brain works like optimally. And, you know, you can just go about your day and just smash stuff.
Yeah.
That's why you want to eat healthy. That's why you want to.
That should be your main motivation, like, not to live forever, but to live as best as you possibly, get the most out of your day, basically.
Yeah,
like, achieve the most out of your day, be the most awake, be the most switched on, be the most, you know, not groggy feeling and stuff.
In terms of sleep, I do believe you use Sleep Cycle, right? Which,
I
use as well, which I used last night, actually, and I got a 78%, which is a bit bad. It's not very good. It's not very good, but you use an eye mask as well and earplugs, right?
Yeah.
And
essential. Dark room,
right? So dark room, mask and earplugs for sleep. And throughout the day, you're drinking green smoothies, taking supplements, eating a healthy diet, which has got superfoods all throughout your healthy diet.
Yeah.
So like, in terms of superfoods, you know, there's a book by Jamie Oliver that he's just brought out called Jamie Oliver's Superfoods. A lot of that you already use in pretty much every meal. Like, he's trying to fit like superfoods like kale and spinach and stuff and broccoli into like
meals.
Pizza. To make like a superfood pizza, you know, because it's for the general. It's because it's for the general public, right? It's the general public want to eat pizza. They don't want to buy a book that's like.
Disclaimer: if you have like fucking pizza full of wheat, a bit of kale on the top, it's not gonna do shit.
Yeah.
So
you should have that on the back of his book, Jamie Oliver. He might have got rid of turkey Twizzlers, but he's still trying to make superfood pizza and pasta.
Yeah.
So that's quite cool. And what we'll do now is we'll dive into the questions. We've got some interesting questions that some of these will need elaborating on, some of them won't. Let's dive into question number one. I think how to burn fat while you sleep could be beneficial. I.e. when to stop eating on an evening and if there are any specific exercises, cardio, squats or press-ups, that keep your metabolism running hot overnight. So I've heard about this. I've heard you're not supposed to eat after a certain point at night because your metabolism slows down while you're sleeping. And you can tend to put on weight if you eat late. Do you think there's any truth to that?
Not really, because overall, like, if you're, it depends about how much you're eating throughout the day, because, you know, most of the stuff digests quite slow. So even if you eat late, even if you eat like quite a few hours before, like, you're still gonna have stuff going into your bloodstream. So, like, it matters what you eat throughout the day, basically. Like, your total calories.
Yeah, so just concentrate on total calories rather than time of day you eat, is what you're saying.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, there's stuff you can do to be a bit healthier. But carbs at night, like, I actually prefer carbs at night because what happens when you eat carbs is your body naturally releases serotonin. And when you've got an abundance of serotonin, then that can convert into melatonin, which helps you sleep deeper. So I would actually recommend to eat some carbs before bed, because it means, you know, you can sleep deeper.
That melanin, yeah.
Melatonin, yeah. And then you get a better sleep, you can recover better and you feel better.
Yeah, man.
So you've got to eat before bed.
And the second part of it, is there any specific exercise to keep your metabolism running hot overnight?
Yeah.
There is things that I've read in books about cold showers, for example. Could you say, you know, anything about that?
Cold showers are good, mainly for recovery. Helps increase your metabolism while you're in the cold shower, so you're like shivering and shit like that. In terms of like burning fat at night, heavy weight training is the best for that, because if you're doing like a muscle building type training and you're breaking down that muscle, for the next few days after that, your muscle is using energy to recover again. So say if you weight train on Monday, you're actually burning calories Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, maybe Thursday, like just from that training session. So actually, you know, a lot of people think cardio is like the best thing to increase metabolism and stuff. Weight training actually leans you up the most, as well as giving you that muscle mass.
Well, there is that, where more muscle you have, the more, you know, your metabolism boosts, right? Like, for example, one of the reasons you have to eat that much as it is your muscles are making you burn more food. So if you don't eat more food, it's going to end up, you know, taking itself. So if you build more muscle, your metabolism increases. Right.
Exactly. And that's the best way to stay lean over like a long period of time, is by building you know, an amount of muscle mass. So, you know, even if you do go out and like you eat a pizza or something, you go over calories, like your calories are so high anyway, you're not even making a dent into it. They like, I could go and I could eat like 3 large Domino's pizzas and not gain.
Yeah.
Not gain like.
Yeah, yeah.
Gram.
Because you know, metabolism's that high, they'll
exactly.
just completely get rid of it completely. Yeah, that's quite interesting. You know much about cold showers? Do you think the benefit of a higher metabolism after a cold shower is true?
While you're in the cold shower, you know, your body needs to produce warmth itself. So you do actually, it helps to burn a few more calories. I wouldn't use it as your main...
calorie burning technique.
Yeah, calorie burning technique. I'd use weight training.
It's one of the things that's just you can add if you like.
It's really good for recovery though. Like post-workout, doing cold showers really helps with recovery.
Yeah, yeah, that's quite cool. Let's go on to the next question.
Sure.
And Jason says, I have skinny legs, help. So he can actually build more muscle on his upper body and whatnot, but less on his legs. What would you say about that? So he can actually put on weight, this is the funny part, he can put on weight for the second part of his body, but not necessarily his legs.
Yeah.
He may say, keep having skinny legs.
Yeah, I mean, like, some people, everyone has them lacking body parts, and, you know, they just don't grow as fast as other things. Like, for me, it was legs. But you can overcome that by just training it more and training it better.
Yeah.
It's probably not optimized as leg training.
Yeah, so if you've got like a lacking part of your body, you might want to concentrate on that particular group, right?
Yeah. Sure.
And work on that particular group to, you know, make
it. Have a look at some videos and, or get a trainer or something to see, you know, what you're doing wrong. So that you maybe just be doing the exercises a little, you know, a little bit off maybe.
Yep, cool. And next question. How to create a diet that builds a body like yours? So let's go for starts, you actually do create diets for people to build bodies exactly like yours, or to build body, depending on what they want really.
Yeah.
So somebody can come to you and say, I want this specific type of body, I work out this many times a day, I want to eat this many meals, and you'll say, okay, here you go. So that's something you actually provide, depending on what they want, what goal they want to achieve, for example.
Yeah.
To create one that's like yours, I guess it goes up in stages, right? You wouldn't just start on a 4,500, like...
Yeah, exactly.
You wouldn't just jump up to, like, yours. I think you'd build up, I'm thinking, like...
Yeah.
Along with your weight training.
So, yeah, as you get bigger, you know, you have to eat more to gain more weight. But, obviously, you don't want to eat 4,500 calories straight away because, you know, them extra few hundred calories help put your body in that surplus for... that muscle building state, but over that it just stores it as fat basically. So you want to kind of manage it so you're building enough muscle but you're not gaining too much fat. I mean, if you've seen any of my pictures from the last, you know, from the beginning of when I started training, like I've never really been above 13% body fat, and that's why, like, you just like slowly ramp it up as your muscles get bigger.
Yeah, overall watch how many calories you're having and watch how much you're burning, right? Like,
yeah.
Overall, like, the reason you've never been above 13 is probably because you've always monitored your macros.
Pretty much.
Simple
yeah.
as that. Like, you've just constantly been on top of exactly how much you need and how much you need to consume to keep your body at a certain... I think that's the key that a lot of people don't realise. They're looking for like, the next diet or the next pill or the next cheat or the next code through it, when it's as simple as watching what you eat.
Yeah, and then training.
Exactly. Yeah, like going to the gym and training and watching exactly what you eat. Like, just make sure that it's the right amount of calories for what you're trying to achieve. Like, if you want more, eat more. If you want less, eat less. Yeah, that's quite cool.
Exactly.
Move on to the next question. And if you're a complete beginner, where do you start? How do you know what regime to do that's right for you? So, now, again, this is something you do once again. Like, you train guys specifically dependent on their actual goals.
Yeah.
So, for any guys that are watching from GambolMe, you do actual meal plans.
And
so,
plans, yeah.
He'll have a chat with you. He'll chat with you and say, like, you know, what goals are you trying to achieve? How much do you weigh? What's your height?
Yeah.
Yada, yada, yada. And you'll build a training regime, a diet, and you'll even coach them through it as well, through... You know, you've got a mastermind program as well, I believe, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So there is that that you can do. If he wanted to without that, how would he get started? He does have to research and find out.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest, like, for me to sit here and, you know, tell him all the stuff that you need to know, like, as a beginner. Like, if you don't know anything, just buy a fucking program. Like, I spent 2 years, like, pretty much making no gains at the beginning. And if I just had someone to give me a good program to make, you know, to stick to, like, make some proper gains on.
I'd back, like, that one up as well. I think anyone who's been into the gym knows that they spent a period of time in limbo, but like, spending a lot of time in the gym, you know what I mean, thinking, what's going on? Like,
exactly. And like, at the beginning, you just don't know what's going on. You need something as a reference to go, okay, that's, like, something that works. It's like, you spend a year, you spend like 40 quid on gym a month, you spend probably like 50 quid on protein powder a month, because you're probably drinking like 10 scoops of protein a day.
Yeah, you don't make exactly how much and stuff.
Like, you probably buy gym gear, etc. That's probably like 500 quid's worth of stuff for a year. You basically waste it.
Yeah.
As you pay like 50 quid for a plan and then make some, like, some real gains. Yeah. So, like, that's what I would do as a beginner. Like, yeah, I could say, like, you know, train heavy, do like 3 sets and whatever, blah, 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 blah. There's just so much to say that just buy a plan.
And it's dependent as well on each individual, I assume, as well. It's not like you can tell some dude to, like, do one way or the other. It's like you need to actually get to know the person's criteria.
Yeah, sure. So, like, if you've got a plan, for me, I send you through, like, a questionnaire. And so that answers, you can answer all the questions that I'd need to know about, you know, your life, your activity levels, what you're eating now, and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's kind of like how that works.
Awesome. Next question. What are the 3 biggest things that stop athletes developing a great body?
What are the
3 biggest failures people make to get into your stage? I'd say at least one of them is not eating enough, right?
Yeah. Not eating enough. Not training hard enough, not training heavy enough, and then, let's see, maybe not drinking enough water.
Really?
Yeah, water is quite important, because, water is important, so that's why we say that.
So we've gone into...
Or consistency, actually.
Consistency, yeah.
Missing workouts, because gym is like, you know... It's not that hard. Once you know what you're doing, it's not that hard. It's just about consistency, making them like small, tiny growths over a period of time. You miss workouts, you miss...
The key to motivation, right? The key to motivation for the guys watching, you guys, you make your plans while you're motivated. I think this is Elliot Hulse's quote. You make your plans while you're motivated, but you stick to them regardless. So when you're motivated, that's when you make your plans that you're going to stick to when you're not motivated, because motivation's a very brief thing that you get. Like, you're very motivated, I'm going to do this, and then it wears off. But you make your plans while you're motivated, and you stick to it regardless. So consistency is as important in every area of life you want to achieve anything in, no matter what, especially in the gym, I assume, right? You start missing days, your body starts doing different things, you start putting on weight because you're eating a calorie surplus if you're trying to gain weight, or if you're not trying to gain weight and stuff, you know, it can go wrong. So consistency is
consistency is key.
Yeah, awesome. And the other two that we already tapped on, which is not eating enough because your muscles need food. And what was the middle one? Water.
Yeah, water is important as well. Drinking enough water. Because you're not going to have energy. It's actually quite difficult to build muscle as well if you're dehydrated. So stay hydrated.
So what are the most common myths in the nutrition and fitness circles you see? Wahey.
Common myths.
The biggest.
So many myths.
What would you say is the most popular one right now? Like the most popular myth that everybody's running along. It might be a diet, it might be a training program, it might be a style of anything.
Yeah. I don't know. Probably biggest myth or like controversial myth is like in fitness, like the only thing that counts is macros. Like, if it fits your macros, people, like, they're like, if you stick to your macros, that's like the only thing you can do to kind of like improve, basically. There's no like other little things like boosting the testosterone or like affecting other hormones or other shit like that. that can help improve you. So that's probably quite a big myth, but I don't know. It's a lot of newbies that are like, people think you can lose fat in like one area.
So they're like, yeah, I've seen that.
It's like,
how do I just lose belly fat?
Yeah. It's like, oh, I just want to lose this fat here. And it's just like, and then you've seen them at the gym, like these guys with like these huge guts like this, doing sit-ups like that, thinking that the sit-ups are going to like reduce their belly
fat. Get rid of that bit of belly
fat. But, you know, the truth is you just lose body fat evenly over your whole body. So you just need to lose weight, lose body fat overall, if you want to lose it in specific areas.
Cool. If you could recommend one book on nutrition and one book on fitness, what would they be?
Any of Arnold's books, really.
Yeah, I've read a lot about Arnold's books recently. Have you read one of those?
I've had a bit of... I've flicked through...
You've read Brain Foods, right? What's it called? Ultramind Solution?
Yeah.
What did you think of that?
In terms of health stuff, not really to do with fitness, but Ultramind Solution is probably the best book I've read in terms of like nutrition and health.
It's definitely got an interesting challenge at the end of it where he tells you to cut everything out and monitor how you feel.
Yeah.
So it's like, all right, if you didn't believe me throughout this book, cut all the things out that I'm mentioning and monitor how you feel over like a 3-week period, and then slowly introduce the foods back in and monitor how you feel afterwards, which is quite interesting. I found that quite interesting. I found certain things affecting me more than others, which was quite cool. Let's have a look. If I wanted to build a body with the maximum possible strength but with the lowest possible mass, how would I start? Any recommendations?
Just heavy weight, low reps. Powerlifting training, basically.
How does powerlifting and bodybuilding differ?
So powerlifting, you're just trying to lift as heavy weight as possible, and then bodybuilding, you're trying to build as much muscle as possible. So it's not, it doesn't really matter as much about how much weight you lift. It does somewhat, because you still want to do high reps and, you know, high weight. Powerlifting...
it's all about strength, really. It's about the muscles looking, you know, like bigger.
Bodybuilding is more like an art, whereas powerlifting is like just like a straight up sport, like just lift the fucking weight.
Okay, ketogenic diet or carb cycling for cutting?
For cutting, what do you say? I don't know. Like, I've experimented with quite a few things, and to be honest, like, there's not just one way to do something. Like, you know, they say, like, there's multiple ways that you can reach number 4, like 2+2, 1x4, etc.
So
at the end of the day, like, there's so many different ways that you can get to the place you want to be. It's just working out which one you feel better on and which one works best for you.
Yeah, so monitor exactly how you feel following each type of specific diet.
Yeah, for sure. Like, I mean, because... I feel awesome on like high fats, you know, like low carb stuff. But some people, like, they literally just can't even function on that kind of diet.
Yeah.
They just have to smash carbs like high, and then, you know, they build muscle the best like that, and they feel the best like that. So
it's dependent on each person, right? Which
exactly.
is something that's, you know, key about coaching, right? You need to have a word with the client to find out exactly where they are, what they suit, and work to them, if that makes sense. How many injuries have you picked up, and which ones were avoidable? That'd be quite interesting.
Yeah, so only two, maybe three main injuries, and they were all avoidable.
Were they newbie injuries or?
Kind of, yeah. First one was like newbie injury, which is rotator cuff. I've done rotator cuff like 3 times. It's the easiest one to injure, to be honest. Cause,
which
like,
muscle's that?
Rotator cuff's in the shoulder.
Yep.
First time was from bench press, not doing proper form, like, you know, coming down like this on like bench press and doing too heavy weight. You're putting too much stress in the shoulder joint, as you should be coming your elbows 45 degree angle, so you're putting more pressure on the chest. And then second one was rotator cuff again, which was just like doing too heavy on dumbbell shoulder press. So basically, like, just be careful in the movements and not try and be like fucking big man on shoulder press and bench press, because you're just going to end up with a fucking rotator cuff injury, and then you're going to, you know, not be able to train that body part for a month, and then,
screw it,
you know,
basically.
you lose muscle. Let's have a look. The other one was like, I had numbness in my arm for like a month. And that was from, I don't know, I just had like some brand of glutamine, and then like over a few days of using it, I just became numb. And then like the numbness went, and then I used the glutamine again and felt numb again. So like, I don't know about that. Most people are alright with glutamine, but...
Not you. Again, it's about each individual person.
You think like, what the fuck, like, why am I becoming numb from glutamine? It's like quite serious numbness, like I couldn't move my arm basically.
Yeah.
Just work it out.
How to get rid of troublesome stomach fat that just won't go away. Diet just made me too thin in the face. I understand this because my face gets thinner quicker than the rest of my body.
Yeah.
So is there any specific way to target any part of body? Is it just completely random?
Yeah, like, just it's completely random, so it's genetic as well. You just hold it in different places.
Yeah.
Just have to lose it overall. But I mean, there's nothing wrong with having like a thin face.
Yeah. I suppose it gives an impression about the rest of the person, doesn't it, if they've got a thin face.
Yeah.
Yeah, first thing you see, then you think, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it's the opposite for me. Like, probably, even if I was 1% body fat, that 1% would probably still be on my cheeks. So, I reckon vital organs would go first, and then it'd be cheeks.
You'd die, and then your cheeks finally get swollen.
Exactly.
And obviously, we're going to get into the question that everybody wants to know. Every guy goes to the gym. Every reason every guy wants to get slimmer and fitter and whatnot. Well, no, I wouldn't say the only reason. I'd say one of the main reasons.
The main initial motivator.
One of the initial motivators is, and the overall question that we're going to talk about is, do women approach you? Do women find you more attractive, have you noticed? Do women comment on your body? Do you find more Instagram likes, followers, followers on other social networks? Do you get random people commenting on it more? Do you get random friends commenting on it more? Do you get a better reaction from certain people, family members, things like that?
Sometimes. Family members don't give a shit. they've never given a shit. Which is fine. You know, you get people like now and again. It's mostly guys. Girls don't really care as much, but then like I don't really get approached that much. Sometimes like a guy will come up and he'd be like, oh, like, nice arms, bro.
Yeah.
Or like, oh, that's sick, man. Because I guess like as a guy you kind of understand what it takes to get, you know, to get to that level kind of thing.
Yeah.
But as a girl, like, unless it's like a fitness girl, which are quite rare nowadays, they don't understand, really. They just think, oh, like, just go to the gym. I understand, like, it's actually a kind of path to mastery and stuff. And so, they don't really care that much.
Have you found a difference before and after?
Before and after, yeah, because the kind of person that you have to become to get that kind of body.
It's difficult because you've grown in that area as well, I assume, at the same time. So it's hard to actually generally monitor it.
Exactly.
From that point.
It can help with your self-esteem a bit. But then...
I suppose.
If you get small, then I guess that self-esteem would go. So you don't really want to base your self-esteem on that. But what I have found is, like, if you've got no game still, and, like, you've still got a lot of mindset things, a lot of problems in terms of mindset, like, you're still going to get no girls, or, like, very, very few now and again who will, like, bypass that and be, like so obsessed with muscles, but that's like quite rare. It's only a few times that you get like easy layups from that.
Yeah, of course.
But then if you have a good mindset and you have a good game and stuff, like, it does help like a small bit. And I find like it helps to keep girls for some reason. I'm not really sure why. I think they kind of they rationalize the fact that you know, you've got a good body and stuff, kind of rationalize their attraction for you, because girls don't really know like
what's going on.
They don't understand.
No,
they'll
say, oh, it's because of his body. Oh, it's because,
but really you've just been listening to Eckhart Tolle for the last couple of days and you're just like
present in the moment.
Yeah,
you don't need anything, you don't want anything,
not needy, just like having a good time and like
enjoying your own emotions.
Yeah, unreactive and masculine, whatever, like all that shit, man. So sometimes they can rationalise their attraction for you for that, so it can help keep them sometimes.
What about Tinder? I mean, you've got pitches that blow most people away, right? Have you found more matches than somebody who doesn't?
Yeah, I mean, like, my matches, I got like 2 matches like every couple weeks or something from Tinder when I just had like a normal picture. I don't know, maybe I wasn't blessed with like them jawline genetics or something.
Them Scandinavian but, genetics.
Yeah, I mean, I did a couple of competitions and then I posted like my main picture, a competition shot, and like my likes, my matches went up like hugely from that. But
online, it's quite basic to understand that, you know, that something like that matters, because it's all they've got to go off, like your initial vibe, and you can kind of carry a vibe through a photo. I think is what I keep saying is important about online games. You carry the right vibe through a photo, but
It's not a selfie. Like,
yeah, not an annoying mirror selfie. I mean,
I mean, I've had like selfie up there, like just me with my top off or whatever, and I just got no likes. I think the fact that like I'm on stage like doing some shit, and like I look like
optimal as well. That's where you got your fitness to your right perspective.
Yeah, because I think they look at that and they go like, "Fuck, it's actually like, that's pretty impressive."
Yeah, that's pretty cool. That's definitely interesting.
Plus, you get all the gym girls.
Yeah,
which the gym girls. Which are the best girls anyway, so.
For you, yeah. That's the thing as well. If you actually post photos that aren't necessarily going to get the mass amount of likes, but then they're going to get the most amount of girls that you're going to be interested in.
Yeah.
So, an example of this is a guy that I knew who's like a bit of a goth or whatnot, and he's quite like, you know, metalhead and whatnot, and he'd refuse to take pictures wearing normal stuff. He'd always go for the cape, the boots, thing, and he'd always say like, "Oh, I'm not getting many matches, not getting many matches." And it's like, you're not going to get many matches, but however, the matches you do get are going to be girls that are into that.
Yeah.
So you can either go to the park and wear a jumper and some jeans and look normal and get more matches, or you can carry on with the boots and the cape and get the matches that are into.
Yeah,
so it's like you can either get normal photos where your body's covered up and you don't look like a competitor, or you can get the matches that are generally going to connect with you the most by putting the competitive photos up.
Possibly, yeah.
Which is always something to reconsider.
I mean, I still wear some like normal girls and stuff as well, but it just means, you know, I get the gym girls.
Yeah, that's quite cool. Cool, so I think we'll wrap that up there. So that's it for us, guys. Thanks for watching. And if you want to hear more from Charlie, go over to his YouTube channel, which is Charlie McGing, right?
Charlie McGing Fitness and Nutrition.
The same thing for Facebook, if I'm correct.
Yeah, Charlie McGing Fitness and Nutrition on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram.
Yeah, check him out, check his videos out, check out his superfoods, check out his supplements, and check out what he's up to, because he's in Barcelona with me now and the rest of some of the other guys from GambolMe and some of the guys from SSM as well. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Cheers, guys.
Peace.